I've been searching for reasons why we are getting very low FPS in Counter-Strike 2 since its release in mid-2023, and after almost a year of looking for answers, I'm going through benchmarks to reading Reddit posts. I think I have the answer, okay? You have a shitty CPU. But wait, it's more complicated than that. Source 2 was reported to be able to use much more of your system than CSGO ever could, but what they failed to mention is the fact that the game is still very CPU based. We are all in awe of the graphical upgrades, even though you still don't need a super expensive graphics card to run the game. Want proof? Sure. Here's a clip of a benchmark where a player is getting around 300 FPS in the game. Take into account that he is using the Nvidia GeForce GTX 1070 Ti. But if you think about it, that is a GPU from 2017. That's 7 years ago. It is also a card that is somewhat comparable to the AMD RX 6600. The graphics card isn't what is important here though, the CPU that he is using is. Let me know which CPU you are using right now and I'll try and guess in the comments which graphics card you are using with it. But the CPU that he was using here is the Intel Core i5-13600K. That's right, if you were to use the same graphics card but with a different CPU, let's say the Ryzen 5 2600, he would have gotten 125 FPS on average instead of the 300 that he is getting right now. In my case, I have the Ryzen 5 5600G and a RTX 3070. So if you quickly think about it, I should be getting like a heckload of FPS in CS2, right? Well, no. I'm getting an average of around 180 to 250 FPS, and that is because of my CPU. I have the 5600G instead of the 5600X. If I had the latter, I would have gotten between 300 and 400 FPS depending on which game mode I play. That is a solid 100 FPS difference, just because of the CPU variation. Now imagine what an entirely different CPU could have gotten me, something crazy. If on the other hand you don't want to spend any money, here's some tips on how to maybe get some extra performance out of your game using the launch options. Don't worry, none of these will actually break your game and you can just delete the launch option or command if you don't want it. First of all, go to your game in Steam, then right click and select properties. In the middle of the new window you will see launch options. I would recommend using these commands first. The first one is -high. No, this doesn't make you or your game high, but it makes the game run at a higher priority than other programs in the background, possibly freeing up some free performance for the game. The second one is -freak, and then you can follow that by the refresh rate of your monitor. It's freak for frequency, not freak for, you know, being a freak. This launch option forces the game to run at the same refresh rate as your monitor while not capping the FPS. It might just help you get a smoother game if you forgot to set your refresh rate in the game itself. The third one is a 50-50. It's called -vulkan. It forces the game to run on the Vulkan API instead of DirectX. While it may help with FPS in some systems, it may cause more stuttering in others. Then an extra one I personally use is -nojoy. This disables the joystick compatibility of the game since I don't think anyone would actually want to play CS2 with a joystick. There are also some commands that you can try out in the game itself that might help you a bit. If you feel that it helps you a lot however, you can put it in your autoexec file or let me know in the comment section down below if you want to know how to create one in the first place. The first one is +cl_force_preload1. This setting forces the game to pre-render models before getting in the game, possibly making the game run much smoother. If any of you know any launch options or console commands that helps with FPS, let us know in the comments so that everybody can try it out for themselves. Another console command that I would recommend you use is fps_max_0. So the 0 means that it doesn't cap your FPS in any way, shape or form, so it will allow you to use the best performance that you can possibly get out of your system. Otherwise, you can cap it at your refresh rate of your monitor, or maybe like 2 FPS above, so that you know that the game and your monitor always displays the same refresh rate. That also helps limit the system to cause less stuttering. So if you're ever stuck in the situation where you feel like you should be getting much more FPS in CS2 and then blame it on the game's bad optimization, then remember this, it might not actually be the game. If you would like to know which PC is perfect not only for CS2 but also for future-proofing your PC without breaking your wallet, go check out the video where I show you the perfect CS2 gaming PC.